from the heart of America in Chicago, Illinois.
It's time for Roker Radio with Al Roker Jr. And now, Al Roker Jr.
How you doing, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Roker Radio. Al Roker Jr. or Roker Radio at home. All the Roker Radios are at home, basically. But since the Tonight Show is the Tonight Show at home, and Jimmy Fallon at home, and Stephen Colbert at home, it's Roker Radio at home. How you doing, everybody? Dano with me, as usual, via Zoom. What's up, brother?
Via Zoom my ass, bro. I'm at the beach. I'm doing great. How are you?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Mayor Lightfoot.
You would be one of those bozos at the beach, like those spring breakers.
Don't get me started, bro. Like, there's people in my rearman that they're having some folks over again.
Are you serious? Another party?
Yeah, we'll find out how much folks they have. I heard multiple voices. There's supposed to be two in the back, but I hear more.
I'm telling you, call the police on them, dude. Call the police on them.
Oh, bro. Well, fuck it. We'll see. We'll see if it gets to 10. If not, you might see me on the news.
Yeah, there you go. So I've been thinking, and it's like, I want to do more of these shows, but I've been thinking, I've been perplexed because I don't know. I'm like, well, do I want to not talk about coronavirus because all anybody anywhere is talking about coronavirus? So do I not want to talk about coronavirus? Do I just want to tell dick jokes and just try and be funny and take people's minds off of it for half an hour or whatever? Or can I not ignore the elephant in the room? And usually I'm the elephant in the room, but now this COVID-19 is the elephant in the room. It is affecting everyone's life. It's not just affecting our lives here. It's affecting everyone's life in the world. I mean, it's crazy. It's like, I'll just be sitting around watching like the 40th straight episode of like Diners, Drive-Ins and Dives or something, because there's nothing on television. And I'm like, oh, that restaurant's closed. Or, oh, Guy Fieri's sitting at home right now doing nothing, just like I am. It's just, it's weird, you know? It's just, so what I've decided to do is not ignore the elephant in the room, but I want to check in on my friends and see how they're doing, and I want to see how you're handling it, and maybe by us talking about how we're handling it, it can help some other people handle it. So, how have you, so I haven't, as we record this, I have not been outside for over a month. I have not left the house in over a month, period.
You're like a bear hibernating.
I have not even left my property. I have only gone out on my porch twice in the last 33 days, let alone gotten in my car, gone around the block.
No, like what's... Going around the block is literally like going around your yard, because you have like fucking your yard is like a mall, like a strip mall.
Yes, but I haven't even gone and like walked around the house or walked around the yard yet. I haven't even done that.
That's what I mean. It's fucking crazy.
I have not gone outside. Well, see, here's the thing, and I want to know if you have. You probably don't have the same anxiety level as I do. And by the way, we're recording this on Zoom so I can see Dano, and in case other people join in later on, we have that capability. So that's the audio you're hearing. So I apologize in advance. But every time I turn on the news, and it's impossible to avoid, and my wife keeps telling me, stop watching coronavirus 24/7. You don't have to watch coronavirus 24/7. And I'm like, I'm not trying to watch coronavirus 24/7. It's just everywhere. It's unavoidable. But here's the thing. So they come out, they go, well, you know, if you're elderly, this is bad for you. Then they come out, they go, well, if you have diabetes, this is bad for you. If you have heart disease, this is bad for you. If you have high blood pressure, this is bad for you. If you have asthma, this is bad for you. And then in the last week and a half, if you're black, this is bad for you. If you're a man, this is bad for you.
Hey, what blood type are you?
I don't know, but I'm probably the wrong blood type.
If you're A, you're fucked.
Yeah. So I have a lot of anxiety over this. As a matter of fact, Pritzker, the governor of Illinois, said in the press conference a few days ago, he said, everyone will probably get this disease. Everyone. And so I'm thinking, so does this mean that I'm not going to leave the house for a year and a half until there's a vaccine?
Yep.
Because I don't want to, because, you know, you keep hearing, you know, oh, well, okay, so 80% of the people, you know, they catch it, or, you know, X amount of people catch it, but it's not too bad. And some people catch it, and they get it, but they're bad. And then there's a certain percentage, and then they go into the hospital, and then there's a certain little small, it's 2% of the people, it's fatal for 2% of the people who get it, 2% or 1%. But what they don't say, and they go, and of those people that died, they had the pre-existing conditions. Okay, I want to know what's the percentage of the people that have the pre-existing conditions that get it, that die?
Yeah.
See?
It's high.
It feels like a game of Russian roulette to me, and every couple of weeks they put another bullet in the chamber.
Well, shit, bro. It's like every few days they're learning different portions of it. I mean, it's not something that we have a grasp on, and that's the scariest part. Is, you know, as fucking crazy as you could seem or sound, saying I haven't left the house in fucking 3 months, it's gonna probably be longer because, truth be told, you can't fucking get this. It's not anything, you know, your lifestyle or this or that. It's just, you know, the roll of the dice on what kind of flu bug this is and what kind of fucking virus this is that attacks people that have eaten pretty, you know, well in the past. It hits certain blood types. It doesn't differentiate from shit. It's just a matter of how your body could absorb this. Some people are a heavier set that fucking overcome it. Some people don't. You just don't know how it's going to hit you. So that's the thing. It's like, did somebody sneeze on something that, you know, it's about how much of a dose you get. Like some of these doctors, bro, there's some of them are in like the best shape possible, but because they're around it so much, they have a stronger dose of the virus in them. It fucking kills them. Why are these doctors dying? Because they're not sleeping. They're anxious. They're stressed out. It's fucking up people with stress. It's people who are depressed.
Firefighters, police. You know, all these healthcare workers. And again, all these healthcare, we talked about this last time, dude, all of these healthcare workers, all of these people working at the grocery store, all, you know, all these people who are, you know,
delivery drivers,
right. And they're not making top dollar. They're not getting hazard pay. They should all be getting some type of hazard pay. When I was a traffic reporter, you would get paid extra money if you got into the helicopter, if that was your job, because that was considered, it was hazard pay.
How many times did you do that?
I've never been in a helicopter. I'll tell you a quick story. I've never been in the helicopter, but I was supposed to do traffic from the Goodyear blimp once. I was supposed to do a traffic from the Goodyear blimp. I was psyched. And the day I was supposed to go up in the blimp, it was too windy, and so they canceled it.
How is it too windy for a fucking blimp? Isn't it like 100 yards long?
But it's still a bunch of floating air. So if it's too windy, it gets jostled around, and it's not safe. So,
or was it one of the, was it the Goodyear blimp, or was it one of those like private ones?
No, this wasn't like the MetLife blimp or something with Snoopy on it.
Okay.
This was the original, bro. This was the Goodyear blimp. and I forget what it was in town for. It might have been the Air and Water Show or something like that, but it was the Goodyear blimp, and I was supposed to go up in it. And I know, blimp in a blimp. I get it. Yes, I know. Very funny, all you motherfuckers out there cracking jokes right now. Very funny, motherfucker.
Hey, bro. Yeah. Hey, but hey, seriously, like you brought up a topic in terms of like people getting hazard pay. Like right now, in your condition, how much would you have to make an hour to like get the fuck out of the house and actually do some of those jobs?
Not worth it. It's not worth it to me. Technically, I'm unemployed, underemployed. I do a radio show out of my house that doesn't pay enough to pay any bills, but it, you know, keeps me active and gives me purpose. So that's great. But I asked Claire. I said, because I think there was a story about people are getting paid like a ridiculous amount of money to work at the McCormick place, where they've set up the beds.
Yeah.
They're getting paid. The rumor was they're getting paid a ridiculous amount of money to work there. The people who are working
there.
Probably
like the union fees plus like time and a half or double time, triple time, hazard pay and shit. They're probably making $100 an hour.
And I said to Claire, I said, if you were making that money, would you go out and get a job in this, you know? And she's like, absolutely. And I said, you do know that if you catch this, we can't see each other. Now, luckily, I'm living a 3-story house, okay? But I'm like, if you catch this shit or I catch it, but let's say you catch it, you're going to have to stay on the first floor, or you're going to have to stay in 2-3 rooms, and I'm not going to be able to see you. And we're going to have to split the cats up. You take one cat, I take the other cat, because I'm not going to be able to pet the cat, your cat, because he could have it in his fur.
Pet your pussy, cat.
I'm not, we're not going to be able to have sex, even maybe through FaceTime or something. FaceTime. But we're going to have to be completely separated from each other for 14 days, if not more. I just say,
did she run out the door?
She immediately ran out and started licking doorknobs. Immediately, she ran out and started licking doorknobs.
She's like, yes.
This is Roker Radio. So, my boy Dano with me. We're on Zoom. So, I have a question for you, Dano, in regards to this.
Yeah.
So, what was important to you a month ago that's not important to you now? What was something that was like this, you know, you were like, this meant a lot to you a month ago, and now, not so much.
You know what? Not that it's like anything big, but I'm a big fan of just being outside and enjoying the weather when we do have nicer days. So something that I enjoyed or was looking forward to a lot more was this spring, summer, just, listen, man, we're in Chicago. Fucking, what is it, 6-7 months out of the year? It's cold as hell, snow and raining. It snowed today.
We had snow October and heavy snow. October, heavy snow, April. Right?
So like a month ago, I was looking forward to a spring, summer with baseball where I could sit outside, get a good face tan, and enjoy some outdoors. I was busy as hell working. Last summer basically went in a flash. I didn't enjoy it. So it was a matter of looking forward to being outside. Just having a more normal schedule.
And now,
which is gone.
Right. But now that's not terribly important.
You know what? I mean, yeah.
In the grand scheme of things.
None of this is important. I mean, right now it's just hunkering down. I mean, listen, I could be a complete piece of shit and just go outside and do whatever the fuck I want. Literally, like, you know, it's Russian roulette. Like you said, I don't know how this might hit me. There's a couple people that were 30, 35 years old, no underlying health conditions, and still kicked their ass. A lot of people that got this said, like, you know, I don't wish this on my worst enemy. So it's kind of like arrogant to say I could live my life. But I know there's people out there like you that I need to protect. And that's the fucking goal. Is that I could walk around, be sick for 7 to 14 days. I have health insurance. I could get through it. But the matter of the fact is that this shit needs to end and it needs to die. What I think should have happened is literally 4 weeks, 1 month, nobody leave that house. Do what Italy did, what Spain did, what Poland did. My grandma, I talked to my grandma last week. There's fucking military tanks patrolling the streets, cops driving up and down streets. You can't even fucking take a walk. You have to either go to the pharmacy, the grocery store, or you're going to the hospital. Anything else, you're getting locked up, ticketed, and your dumbass is going to probably get beat up by the cops. If we did that for 4 weeks, we probably would have killed this in 1 month.
Okay, but I agree with you. Maybe not in 1 month, but you know, I said all along, I said, you know how you stop this? Nobody has any interaction with anybody for 14 days and it dies off, you know? But to your point, and I want to talk about social media in a minute, and Facebook and how that's a rabbit hole, but there's literally people, when Governor Pritzker brought in the National Guard to help with the drive-through testing and stuff like that, my wife was getting texts from people saying that, oh, I've got my wife has a friend who works in this office and it's going to be martial law.
Could have been.
And that's
we were getting close to it.
And that's from just them calling up some National Guardsmen to help with the drive-through testing locations. People are talking about, oh, yeah, it's going to be martial law. You're talking about tanks in the streets, you know? And it's funny, they came out that there was a report on this on the national level, on the federal level. It was called Operation Red Dawn, based on that Patrick Swayze movie from the 80s.
I read that.
But
yeah.
Let me tell you how I feel about it. I think it's funny, just a little things. Remember how everyone freaked the fuck out when the NBA postponed the season? And then it was like, the NCAA is going to play the tournament with no spectators. Oh, my God. How is this possible? How could that? Oh, this is what's going on here? What kind of world are we living in? And then MLB postponed their season and NBA postponed their season. And then they canceled the tournament and everyone went, oh, my God, they canceled the tournament. Oh, my God. Caesars is going to lose so much money because nobody's betting. And, oh, this is crazy. Now all of that means nothing. Who gives a shit about the tournament right now? Who cares? Yeah. It means nothing. You know,
it's underwhelming in the swing of things. Yeah, it means shit when there's so much more at stake.
Well, you know, you had people the other day, and they're doing this around the country, but this is the one that I saw in Michigan, where they were, they protested, they went to the governor's mansion, and they caused a traffic jam, because I wanted to say, it was called Operation Gridlock, because they wanted them to open up the economy, open up, and they're interviewing this one woman through her car window, and she's like, this is America. I need to go out and get my hair done. And she bent down and showed how her roots were showing and stuff like that. I should be able to go and get my hair done and I should be able to do this and do that. This is America. And then the governor of Michigan said, it's funny that these people are out here protesting because they want us to open things back up. And because all of these people decided to come together and congregate and do this, it may delay exactly what it is that they're trying to fight for.
Some bunch of idiots.
Some people still just don't get it. They don't get it.
Well, they're not rational. They're fucking making stupid ideas. They make a Facebook event and they congregate. of those intellects of the world, I call them. Those are the smartest people in the world, bro, because we're dumbasses because we don't see the world their way. You know, they are trying to lead the charge to open up America again. Everything I'm saying is sarcastic as fuck.
Yes, I know.
They're dickheads. But no, man, I heard about that story, and it defeats the purpose of what they're trying to do. So they created, what, a gridlock over an idea about letting them drive around and shit?
Well, they created gridlock because they wanted them to they wanted to protest to have them open up the economy. But he's going, the mayor's going, or the governor's going, the fact of the matter that all you people came together and did this, we could now have a cluster.
14 more days.
And exactly. Listen, the Roker Radio, Dano, I appreciate your time. I know that we're going to, and I want to say that I have truly enjoyed our virtual Zoom happy hours that we've been having once a week on the weekends. So I'm looking forward to our next Zoom happy hour for sure.
I would like to thank Lagunitas for supplying us with IPAs and Basil Hayden bourbon. You guys make the Fridays go by a lot faster. Our evenings turn into mental mush. But if you guys want to send more booze our way, we'll happily take it.
Absolutely. And I just want to make a couple of quick points before we go that I find funny. Not funny, but I find it ironic. Andrew Yang, do you remember him?
Yeah, he was one of the early presidential candidates.
Yeah, he didn't drop out till late. He was probably one of the last five to drop out. But yes,
he was getting some steam. I read a lot about that kid.
Do you remember what Andrew Yang was running on to stimulate the economy?
To give a monthly stimulus to people?
He said that we'll give everybody in the country $1,000. We'll give everyone in the country $1,000 to stimulate the economy. Yeah. And they went, this guy's a nut job. He's crazy. Huh. So what happens? Oh, everybody in the country is getting $1,200. Bernie Sanders said, Medicare for all. Health care is a right. It's not a privilege. Huh. Now everybody gets tested for COVID-19 for free. Interesting. Global warming. Global warming's BS. It's a hoax. It's the Democrats are trying to do, and I'm not trying to be political. This is not a political show. I like people to listen to the show, and I want to keep my listeners. I'm not trying to be political. I'm just trying to make a point. There's so many people out here who don't believe in the science of global warming. And now we're going to let the science dictate everything that happens with the disease. When are you going to reopen the economy? Well, we're going to let the science dictate that. When are we going to
even that?
I just think that this is like a microcosm of everything. This is global warming. This is global warming sped up 100 times.
Shit, man. I made an analogy earlier. It's like it's one of those fucking horror movies where you're yelling at the character like, you're an idiot. Just stay the fuck home. You're going to ruin this for the country. Or you're like, holy fuck, they're going to die first in the movie because they're being assholes. And we're like, we're literally in that aquarium. We're the ones in that fish tank that we're like, fuck this. This will never happen to us. But we're in the midst of it. And a lot of people are talking about opening the economy. The economy means shit right now. The dollar means shit right now. We might continue a virus that has no cure. That means it's going to kill people left and right. There's going to be unemployment. There's never going to be certain things opening like concerts for the next year or year and a half until there's a cure.
Yeah, there's not going to be any concerts or huge sporting events where there's people gathering like that until you have a vaccine. Absolutely. And the thing is, and I'll give you want your movie analogy. I'll give you the movie analogy. Jaws. They're going, we need to reopen the country. We need to get the economy moving again. These are the people who don't understand that if everybody's dead, there is no economy. They don't understand that. They don't understand if they open up the economy too soon and there's another huge wave and a huge cluster and a whole bunch of other people die, then you still have no economy and a bunch of dead people. Okay, they don't understand that. But this is Jaws. We got to open up the beaches. We got to open up the beaches. This is a tourist town. This is how we make our living, is the people coming to the beaches every summer. We got to open up the beaches. And Roy Scheider's going, there's still a shark out there. We can't open up the beaches until we kill the shark.
That's a good one. That's perfect.
That's what's going on. So, and you know, I talk about, you know, Twitter and Facebook. Facebook is really, I mean, it's like you can just get sucked in. I literally, and I'll leave it at this, a friend of mine, she's not a very close, for someone I went to school with, but sadly, her mother passed away from COVID-19. And I sent her condolences. And like, there were people like fighting with her on Facebook saying she didn't die from COVID-19. She was already sick, blah, 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 stuff like that. So I sent her a message. I'm like, don't listen to these assholes. They're stupid. Just, I'm so sorry for your loss, blah, blah, blah. I go on Facebook the other day, and she's talking about what a dipshit Pritzker is because he won't open up the economy. And she has friends who are losing everything. They're small business. They're losing everything. And he doesn't want to open up the economy. And this is a person that just lost their mother to COVID-19. So sometimes I really don't get it.
I don't get it, man. I mean, listen, people have a strong opinion on something that affects them. And sometimes they don't have an opinion until it doesn't affect them. People like her, unfortunately, hopefully she's not listening. You know, certain people lose certain situations of money is always king, and some people will trade in the health over having some bucks. I don't know what to say to something like that. I think I would be mentally fucked if my parents just died from this shit. I haven't seen my family because of that worry. So right. Me having to go through something like that, the last thing on my head would be a fucking small business. No offense to everybody going through shit, but that just wouldn't be top of mind.
Well, you know, I
fire me, let me go, whatever the fuck. I don't care. I'll figure out a smaller apartment. I will downsize my Comcast bill. There's other ways around this shit, but family health is first, because without that shit, you can't make a dollar.
Well, I've thought to myself many a times, I'm like, well, if I were actually still working at the Loop or whatever, and they said, yeah, you got to come in. Cause I talked to, I texted with Mancow a couple of weeks ago, and he said he's still doing the show from the station. Abe is still going into the station. And I said, you know, if they told me I had to go into the station, I'd be like, I'm not coming in. I'm not coming in. I'm high risk. I'm not coming in. I'm not coming downtown and going to the NBC tower every day. I'm not going to do it. And if you have to you have to fire me.
Oh, no, I just left the job because of that type of shit. I had to turn in my shit 2 days early. Because my boss was being a little paranoid, and I told him, I'm not coming in. I could work from fucking home. Like, yeah, and he thought I was paranoid and I was crazy, and like everybody travels to work. I was like, I don't have to. This is my last week at the office. I'm not traveling via CTA Blue Line, bro. Sorry.
Absolutely. I mean, and you know, and my wife lost her job. She was one of the first people to lose her jobs because she works in the hotel industry, right? And she was distraught. And I said, you know what? There's nothing we can do about it. Our only responsibility right now is to stay safe. That's the only responsibility. Bills, everybody's going to have bills. Broke, everybody's going to be broke. Fucked, everybody's going to be fucked. We can't afford to be fucked and sick.
At the same time.
Right, because we lost our health insurance too when she got fired.
Yeah.
And just to bring it back around with me being high risk and all of the different things that they seem to add on every week, I consider myself lucky because I have enough insulin to last another 9 weeks. I was able to get a doctor's appointment right before this shit went down and find out that, you know, my blood pressure is good. My diabetes is under control. I got all of my prescriptions refilled. I was able to get all my prescriptions in. I consider myself to be extremely lucky. Extremely lucky.
And if you waited a week.
If I had waited, it wouldn't even have been a week. If I had waited, yes. If I had waited till, if I had gone, if it had been, if my doctor's appointment had been the next Wednesday, other than the Wednesday that I went, the bars and restaurants would have been closed and the city would have been 3/4 of the way to being shut down.
Man, that last week I hit up a dentist appointment. I hit up my doctor for a physical and got lucky as hell, man. Got it under the belt.
There you go. Well, listen, brother, stay safe. You and your family and your friends, stay safe. I end when I do my radio show, I end the show with hashtag flatten the curve, hashtag stay home, save lives. So I'll say stay the same to you. Flatten the curve, stay home, stay safe, save lives. Next time I'll talk to you, it'll be Zoom happy hour.
Happy hour.
All right, brother.
Be safe.
Take care. You too. Peace.
Later.
Peace.
And everyone out there, please be safe. Exactly what I just said to Dano, I'm saying to you as well. Stay home. Save lives. Be safe. I wish you all the best. I know that you're having problems financially. I know that it's rough out there right now, but the only responsibility you have right now is to stay healthy and not get anybody else sick. If you do that, you're doing a great job. Appreciate it. At Al Roker Jr., Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that kind of stuff. I'm not going anywhere, so I don't know what the hell I'm going to have to Instagram, but hey, check it out anyway. Maybe I'll put something up that's interesting every now and then. Listen, take care, be safe. Talk to you next time. Peace.